Let us see the anatomy of the ventricles. Here is the sagittal section of the brain, part of the sagittal section, showing the corpus callosum here, the different parts of the corpus callosum. This is called the genu, the rostrum is here, the body of the corpus callosum, splenium. Just below it you can see the thalamus, the anterior end of the thalamus, posterior end of the thalamus. Here is the interventricular foramen, and you can see that the hypothalamic sulcus leading towards the cerebral aqueduct. This part is the midbrain, below this is the pons, and you can see the two colliculi, and this part is the midbrain. Next, I am going to show the different portions of the ventricles, and what I want to show here from the rostrum, this is the septum pellucidum, it is going up to the optic chiasma here. So, ventral to the thalamus, antero inferior to the thalamus, actually this area is the hypothalamus. The third ventricle, what you see here, the septum pellucidum has been opened to show part of the lateral ventricle. Here is the third ventricular area, which is mostly occupied, or the lateral wall of the third ventricle, you can see, mostly formed by the thalamus and the part of the hypothalamus. Anatomically, we show the different walls of the thalamus. Anterior wall of the thalamus here, it is formed by the lamina terminalis. Here is the optic chiasma, lamina terminalis. This is the anterior commissure, and this is the fornix. Actually, the whole of the lateral ventricle forms like a C. The fornix along with the lateral ventricle, initially fornix develops in the lamina terminalis, but when the brain grows along with the ventricles, it grows towards the temporal horn also. It is also C-shaped, like the caudate nucleus and the lateral ventricle. So, here is the anterior wall of the lateral ventricle, lamina terminalis, you can see the anterior commissure and the column of the fornix. The two column of the fornix forms the third ventricle. This is the roof of the third ventricle, which is formed by the choroidal fissure actually, which contains the tela choroidea. You can see the fold of pyometer. One of the fold comes, it covers the pineal gland, is a triangular fold, then it through the interventricular foramen, it goes to the body of the lateral ventricle. It comes back and lies below the fornix, then it again goes, covers the splenium of the corpus callosum. Above it, again you can see that this is the fornix and septum pellucidum. So, that forms the roof of the third ventricle. The posterior wall of the third ventricle is formed by the pineal gland, which is mostly damaged, but I have made it. And these are the two stalks of the pineal gland, superior and inferior. The floor of the third ventricle is formed from anterior to posterior by the optic chiasma, then there is a median eminence, and also by the midbrain and cerebral aqueduct, posteriorly by the colliculi, where there is a junction between the posterior wall and the floor. So, this portion is the floor of the third ventricle. And interventricular foramen, you can see, so here is the anterior end of the thalamus, and anteriorly this is the column of the fornix. The recesses are there. There is one recess here, you can see. The recess between the two columns, the other column of the fornix will be in this side, and above the anterior commissure, this is the anterior recess. Here is the optic recess. The other recesses I cannot show, infundibular somewhere here, in I have a picture. The suprapineal recess is there, and here is the pineal recess. This is showing the structures in the floor of the thalamus from below. These are the two temporal lobes. So, what you can see, the optic nerve, optic chiasma, then the median eminence, the two mammillary bodies, interpeduncular fossa. This is, here lies the posterior perforated substance. You can see the basilar artery with the two P1 segment, and this is the superior cerebellar artery. In between here lies the third nerve, and fourth nerve will be there on the lateral side. This is the uncus, and this is the rhinal sulcus of the gyrus rectus is here. Here is the gyrus rectus, and these two are the olfactory tracts. The floor is nicely seen, the optic nerve, optic chiasma, the optic tracts going towards the thalamus, and this is the ventriculostomy has been already done. So, you can reach from this side the two mammary bodies and the posterior perforated substance is there. So the section is slightly oblique, that is why you can see part of the cerebral aqueduct, the midbrain is here. The aqueduct is triangular in size in this part, and this two are the internal carotid artery, and the M1 segment is there, part of the anterior cerebral artery also you can see. This is M1 segment of the part of the lateral ventricles, junction between the inferior and posterior horn is here. Here is the two thalami and the interthalamic adhesions can be seen. We are looking the brain from below. So, we can see the body of the fornix and the interventricular foramen with the choroid plexus and part of the midbrain. This is the thalamus only, the posterior part of the third ventricle. Actually, this is the junction between the third ventricle and the midbrain, that is why we can see the superior colliculus, and this is leading towards the cerebral aqueduct. The posterior horn is nicely seen. This is the optic radiation fibers of the internal capsule going towards the occipital cortex, and these are the calcarine sulcus, this one and this one is the calcarine sulcus where the visual area lies. This is the third ventricular area which leads into the cerebral aqueduct, but what you can see the lateral ventricle and interventricular foramen, junction between the lateral and interventricular foramen, the two columns of the fornix, septum pellucidum joining, and the choroid plexus from the third ventricle going to the lateral ventricles. On the medial side, thalamus is there. On the lateral side, the head of the chordate nucleus is there. So, that is forming the body of the lateral ventricle. Here is the body of the lateral ventricle with the chordate nucleus here on the lateral side, the two columns of the fornix, and these are the two thalami, and this portion is the roof of the third ventricle, interthalamic adhesion, and this is part of the third ventricle, mammary bodies you can see from below, and internal capsule going to form the cross cerebri. Some portion of the substantia nigra can be seen here, is slightly oblique section. So, optic tract, optic nerve and the optic chiasma is there, infundibulum, and pituitary stalk is damaged. So, you can see the opening, and here I want to show you the cortex has turn inside to form the hippocampus. In this side also hippocampus, and the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle is here. Hippocampus is forming the floor of the inferior horn. The medial wall of the inferior horn is here. This is the roof of the inferior horn. This is the floor of the inferior horn. Hippocampus is forming the floor of the inferior horn. So, these are showing the recesses actually. Already I have shown. This is the anterior recess. This is pineal recess, suprapineal recess, the optic recess, the infundibular recess. I got a nice specimen to show the junction between the third and lateral ventricle, where you can see the hypofacial recess and also the posterior commission. Normally we do not see. This is the floor of the third ventricle, the cross cerebri is there. This is the posterior commission actually, just above the two colliculi. The whole third ventricle and the lateral ventricles are seen. This is the chordate nucleus, as you described the ventricles are C-shaped. So, this is the C, the other part of the C you cannot see, it has gone to the temporal lobe. So, this portion is the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle here. Here is the genu. Genu forms the anterior boundary of the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle. The posterior boundary is here near the interventricular foramen. So, the head of the chordate nucleus is here, which is forming the lateral boundary of the anterior horn. The medial side, here lies the septum pellucidum, which has been damaged, okay, and the medial wall of the anterior horn is formed by the septum pellucidum. So, this is the body of the lateral ventricle. You can see the thalamus, here is the whole thalamus, and there is a groove over the thalamus. Here lies the fornix, actually this is a groove for the fornix. The below it is the fissure for the choroid plexus of the third ventricle, which is enters from here, then it enters into the interventricular foramen. Between the fornix and the chordate nucleus, this is the thalamostriate vein, and one fine white matter comes. This is called stria terminalis. Star terminal is actually, it starts from amygdala in the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. It also follows the C, and star terminal is those fibers from amygdala comes and release here. This is the septal area. This is the part of the limbic system. So, lateral wall of the body and the roof of the body of the lateral ventricle is formed by the corpus callosum, which has been damaged here. Part of the posterior horn is here. The junction between the posterior horn and the inferior horn is here. So, the tail of the caudate nucleus, which is going like this, it forms the caudate nucleus along with the stria terminalis, it forms the roof of the inferior horn. You can see the interventricular sulcus, and this area is the hypothalamus. The mammillary bodies are here. You can see the cerebral aqueduct leading to the fourth ventricle. This is the roof of the fourth ventricle. This is the other part of the roof. This is called the superior medullary velum. This is inferior medullary velum, where there is an aperture, foramen of Magendie, through which it the CSF enters into the cerebellopontine cistern. This is the roof of the lateral ventricle formed by the corpus callosum and the two horns you can see, anterior and posterior horn. This is the septum pellucidum, anterior horn is here, lateral wall of the anterior horn you can see here, formed by the head of the caudate nucleus that we have shown in the sagittal section. This is the thalamus. So, in between the two thalami, this area is the third ventricle, and this is the roof of the third ventricle, where you can see the body of the fornix with the choroid plexus, and this is the interventricular foramen. This is the genu of the internal capsule. There are lots of blood vessels here. If you damage this blood vessel, then there is a danger is there, because it is near the genu of the internal capsule. The other horn, this is the posterior horn of the lateral ventricle. This is called forceps major. These fibers of the, this is called forceps minor, fibers which passes anteriorly from the genu, connects the two frontal lobe, that is forceps minor, and the fibers connecting the two occipital lobes is called the forceps major. This forceps major fibers actually, they form an elevation in the medial wall of the lateral ventricle, that is called the bulb of the posterior horn. Below it, this calcarine sulcus forms another elevation called calcar avis. This is the lateral wall. You can see these fibers, actually this gray areas, this is called tapetum. These are the tapetum. Then is the optic radiation fibers are there. This is anterior horn, where septum pellucidum has been, there is a cavity in the septum pellucidum. This is on anterior horn, and you can see the lateral wall, the medial wall of the anterior horn. This is the head of the caudate nucleus, internal capsule, and the lentiform nucleus here. This is the body of the lateral ventricle, where you can see the body of the caudate nucleus and the choroid plexus lying over the thalamus. Thalamus is forming the floor of the lateral ventricle. Floor is here formed by the caudate nucleus and the thalamus. I have shown this one also. The only thing we can see is the anterior commissure here, and the anterior recess is, we are looking it from below, that is why anterior recess you can see above the anterior commissure and in between the two columns of the fornix. Here is the lateral ventricle body and the third ventricle. The internal capsule is continuing as crus cerebri, and after the pyramid you can see the substantia nigra is here, the red nucleus is in this portion, and the thalamus, different nuclei of the thalamus divided by white matter is there. The inferior horn is here. You can see the typical the zebrafish type of structure here. This is the inferior horn, and the medial wall of the inferior horn is here. Okay, lateral wall is here. Now, I will go to the inferior horn. This is the inferior horn. The floor of the inferior horn is formed by the hippocampus, and this is the typical pace hippocampus, paw-like arrangement of the hippocampus, and this area is the dented gyrus. It is not focused, otherwise we could have seen that dentition also, some amount of dentition is seen. Then this is the fimbria. This fimbria actually, it is the beginning of the fornix, and it goes to the body of the lateral ventricle, then it forms the joints from both the sides and forms the fornix. So, What you see here is the floor of the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle, and this is the junction between the posterior horn and inferior horn. So, this is the triangle, the collateral triangle, and this is formed by the collateral sulcus. Actually, inferior horn is from outside. If you go from the superior temporal sulcus, it is parallel to the superior temporal sulcus from outside. The hippocampus is nicely seen. What I was telling, the fibers of the hippocampus, which comes, this is the dentate gyrus, and fibers from the hippocampus and dentate gyrus joins to form the cross of the fornix. This is the cross of the fornix, and it lies below the sphenium of the corpus callosum. Then it forms the body of the fornix. So, this is one of the fornix, and this is the collateral trigone. In the next slide, I will show you that it is the enlarged bigger formation, bigger picture of this, of the inferior horn. At the tip of the inferior horn lies the amygdala. So, this is the inferior horn, and here lies the amygdala. The other side amygdala is not seen. This is the tip of the inferior horn, and this is the almond-shaped nucleus, amygdala, and on the medial side of the temporal lobe, you see, if you go from the medial side, you can reach the amygdala. The fourth ventricle, the roof, already I have mentioned, this is the cerebral aqueduct, this is the roof, and other part of roof is here, inferior colliculus. This is the floor which is formed by the pons and also the medulla. It opens into the spinal canal, central canal of the spinal cord, and also cerebellofrontal angle through the foramen of Meyendi. In the lateral recess lies the foramen of Lasca. So, the whole thing is superior medullary velum. This contains some gray matter, and on the lateral side of the superior medullary velum, there is superior cerebellar peduncle. So, this is the superior cerebellar peduncle coming from the cerebellum, and these are the inferior colliculi. Just below the inferior colliculi, part of the superior medullary velum is there. Here the fourth nerve, this opening through which, the only nerve which comes from the dorsal side, they comes from this opening. So, these are the superior cerebellar peduncle, they are coming from the dentate nucleus here in the cerebellum. The boundaries you can see here, this is the gracile tubercle, and midline this is the gracile fasciculus, cunate fasciculus is lateral to it, cunate tubercle is here. Then continuation of it is the inferior cerebellar peduncle which enters into the cerebellum. Inferior cerebellar peduncle. So, the boundaries are superolaterally, these are the superior cerebellar peduncle, the inferior cerebellar peduncle, and below is the gracile tubercle, cunate tubercle. So, that forms the boundary of the fourth ventricle. And the floor of the fourth ventricle, this is the median sulcus, this is the roof you can see, and here the roof, there is discontinuity, inferior medullary velum, and that is the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle, which is a branch of the pica. You can see some of the branches of the pica which enters through the foramen of Meyendi into the fourth ventricle. Here is the floor in details, median sulcus, and this is the sulcus limitans. In between there is the median eminence, and this is the facial colliculus where the facial knob nucleus is there, and in the upper part of the sulcus limitans there is one area. The fovea is there. Actually, this is the fovea, slightly lateral to the fovea there is a dark area. This contains the dopaminergic neurons of the brain, and in the lower part if you see, this nib like appearance is calamus cryptorius. This is the hypoglossal triangle, and lateral to it, this triangle is the vagal triangle, and this is the tubercle, gracile tubercle, funiculus gracilis, funiculus cunatus. This tubercle is the cunate tubercle, and continuation of this is the inferior cerebellar peduncle. There are some fibers coming from here, so those are called the internal medullary stria, and this area is actually the vestibular area just above the vagal triangle, lateral to the hypoglossal triangle. The vestibular nerve nucleus is there, and this elevation where you can see, this is the cochlear nucleus elevation, and lateral to it, here lies the lateral recess of the fourth ventricle, and it opens anteriorly through the foramen of Lasca. Here is the opening where the foramen of Lasca opens near the flocculus of the cerebellum. So, this is showing the same thing, fourth ventricle recesses, lateral recess. Okay.
very nicely seen. Genu of the corpus callosum and sphenium of the corpus callosum. Here is the lamina terminalis coming from the rostrum. This part is called rostrum, lamina terminalis. Here lies the acom, and sometimes if the aneurysm ruptures, it ruptures the lamina terminalis and blood can be in the ventricles also. So, this is the body of the fornix, the septum pellucidum. So, third ventricle is here. What you see, the interthalamic adhesion, this is the thalamus, the hypothalamic sulcus. Now, I am putting the probe in the interventricular foramen here. Here is the interventricular foramen, and this is the posterior limit, the pineal gland, pineal stalk. You can see pineal gland is not there, and this is the cerebral aqueduct. The two colliculi are here, cerebral aqueduct leading to the fourth ventricle. This is the floor of the fourth ventricle. This is the roof, which is formed by the superior medullary velum, and the foramen of Magendie is here. This is the foramen of Magendie, the calcarine sulcus, and this is parietoxal sulcus. This is the calcarine sulcus. This one is the calcarine sulcus, and these are the anterior cerebral artery. Anterior communicating is not here. Optic chiasma is here. Here is the internal carotid artery. So, anterior cerebral, the branches, the frontal branches, these are the other branches here. It goes up to this area where it communicates with the posterior cerebral branches of the posterior cerebral artery. Now, the lateral ventricle, here is the lateral ventricle, anterior horn, the head of the caudate nucleus is here on the both the sides, and the septum pellucidum is here. Interventricular foramen, nicely seen how the choroid plexus is coming from the anterior horn, and actually interventricular foramen is here where I am putting the, this is the interventricular foramen, and choroid plexus is coming from here. Now you can see the choroid plexus going to the posterior horn. This is the body of the lateral ventricle and the posterior horn of the lateral ventricle. This is the anterior horn of the internal capsule, then genu. This is the blood vessel. So, this is the thalamus and the posterior horn, the optic radiation is there going to the occipital lobe. Calcarine sulcus is here. So, this elevation actually is the calcarevis. The calcarine sulcus is here, and the elevation here is the calcarevis. Okay. One can see the brain stem here, and the cross cerebri is, or the internal capsule is coming as cross cerebri and the pyramid, and here lies the temporal lobe, and I am putting the wire in the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle. I think we can stop now.